On behalf of everyone here at Fontainebleau Junior High, I want to thank you for joining us today as we gather to honor, remember, and recognize the millions of Americans, past and present, whose military service has kept our nation safe and strong, and whose sacrifices have helped preserve the freedoms Americans enjoy today. Please stand as Fontainebleau High School's ROTC color guard presents the colors and remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Colors. Present. Arms. Order. Arms. About. Face. Pose.
Please be seated. When Francis Scott Key wrote the Star-Spangled Banner 200 years ago, he called America the land of the free and the home of the brave. Those words are as true today as they were then. Throughout this nation's history, America's soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, and Coast Guardsmen have bravely answered the call to defend our freedom, to aid our allies and friends, and to turn back aggressors. We can never fully repay our debt of gratitude to the more than 650,000 American service members who died in battle, or the 1.4 million who were wounded. We can, however, recognize and thank the 25 million veterans still living today.
These words are inscribed on the Korean War Memorial in Washington, D.C. Our nation honors her sons and daughters who answered the call to defend our country they never knew, and people they never met. These words applied equally to many of our World War I, World War II, Vietnam War, Gulf War, Global War on Terror veterans as well. They apply to today's active duty service members, tomorrow's veterans who are helping to maintain peace throughout the world. Today, it is our privilege to say thank you to all of America's veterans to let them know that we appreciate them for their service and honors and for their sacrifices. The price of freedom is high. We cannot afford to forget those willing to pay for it. Today, we celebrate America's veterans for keeping this nation the land of the free and home of the brave. For your listening pleasure, please welcome string students Angelina Murillo, Riley Galloway, and David Zong, who will perform America and America the Beautiful. Please welcome our principal, Mr. Mike Askew.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the 2019 Fontainebleau Junior High Veterans Day program. I would like to thank you all for being here today as we celebrate the incredible men and women who have served or are currently serving in our country. I feel honored to stand in front of each of our guests who have served or are still serving in the armed forces. Thank you for your courage and bravery and leaving behind everything that was special to you so that you can protect our freedoms in this great country. Your dedication to this country and willingness to sacrifice your life for others is inspiring, and these courageous acts truly make you a hero. At this time, I'd like to turn it over to the person responsible for setting up this wonderful ceremony, Miss Eileen Scoriels.
Thank you. As I call your name, we ask that you please stand and be recognized and remain standing until everyone in your branch of service has been introduced. We also ask the audience to please hold your applause until all names have been called out. We'd like to recognize all of those that have joined us today. I'm going to do my best with these names. From the Army, Terry Douglas. Leonard Bond. Ray Olson. Matthew Lytle. John DeSalvo. Mel Elslinger. Norman Smith. John Davis Jr. Paul Woods. Shannon Givens. Alvin Givens. Rebecca Greenwood. Larry Foster. David Bradley. Our teacher, Sandra Bradley. Kevin Rappel, a Repel, I'm not sure. Leroy Cooper. Gray Schwartz. Laura Lenfant. Hannah Stansberry. Maurice Patterson. Thank you for your service to our country. I apologize, they didn't sign in. We have two teachers, Charlie Rollins and Dale Simmons as well. Where are you? Where's Coach Simmons? From the Navy, Ronald Zintz, Ron Lorio, Rob Ridenauer, Frank Lodato, Kimberly Miskimmon, and Mark Colonna. We thank you for your service to our country. From the Marines, David Billiot, Carl Rabush, yes, John McInnatus, Bill Morgan, Carl Wilson, Richard Fegan. Thank you for your service to our country. From the Air Force, and I happen to have a nephew who is in the Air Force. Herbert Fauche, Carl Alley, Joanne Lacassane, James Lacassane, Alfred Fontenot, Tim Mitchell, Eric Durrell, Ross English, James Hurston, Mark Winslow, Tyson Schmidt, Sarah Tassan, Lauren Tassan, Kurt Weilbacher. Thank you for your service to our country. I'm very excited about this because we never have anyone from the Coast Guard. Shannon Gilroth, is that right? Joseph Bergeron, Richard Meyer, and Wendy Daigle. Thank you for your service to our country. We are certainly proud of all of these men and women for their sacrifices to this country, and we are extremely, I get very emotional, we are extremely grateful to you for taking the time to come spend with us today. I'll turn it back over to my students.
Under the direction of Miss Alyssa Carranza and with the accompaniment of talented music teacher Dr. Lauren Broad, our chorus will sing Song for the Unsung Hero by Pamela and Joseph Martin. This song is a special tribute to all the men and women who have put and who continue to put their comforts aside and their dreams on hold to preserve America's freedom.
My name is Old Glory. I fly atop the world's tallest buildings. I stand watch in America's halls of justice. I fly majestically over institutions of learning. I stand guard with power in the world. Look up and see me. I stand for peace, honor, truth, and justice. I stand for freedom. I am confident, I am arrogant, and I am proud. When I am flowing with my fellow banners, my head is a little higher, my colors a little truer. I bow to no one. I am recognized all over the world. I am worshipped, I am saluted. I am loved, I am revered. I am respected, and I am feared. I have fought in every battle of every war for more than 200 years. I was flown at Valley Forge, Gettysburg, Shiloh, and Appomattox. I was there at San Juan Hill, the trenches of France, in the Oregon Forest, Anzio, Rome, and the beaches of Normandy. Guam, Okinawa, Korea, and Vietnam know me. I was there. I led my troops. I was dirty, battle-worn, and tired, but my soldiers cheered me, and I was proud.
I have been burned, torn, and trampled on the streets of countries I have helped set free. It does not hurt, for I am invincible. I have been soiled upon burned, torn, and trampled in the streets of my country. And when it is done by those whom I've served in battle, it hurts. But I shall overcome, for I am strong.
I have slipped the bonds of earth and stood watch over the uncharted frontiers of space from my vantage point on the moon. I have borne silent witness to all of America's finest hours, but my finest hours are yet to come. When I am torn into strips and used as bandages for my wounded comrades on the battlefield, when I am flown at half mast to honor my soldier, or when I lie in the trembling arms of a grieving parent at the grave of their fallen son or daughter, I am proud. Author unknown. Our veterans have served our country for over 200 years. The armed forces in our country are the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, Marines, and Coast Guard. There are three general categories of military people. Number one is active duty, which are full-time soldiers and sailors. Number two are reserve and guard forces, which are usually work a civilian job, but can be called to full-time military duty. And number three, which are veterans and retirees that are past members of the military. Today, we have over 25 million living veterans from all branches of the military. Each branch has a unique mission within the overall mission of the United States security and peace. As we call out each branch separately, please stand if you are or were a member of the particular branch.
I am the Army, and I am the oldest of our country's armed forces. I am responsible for most land operations. In wartime, I defend land areas, and in peacetime, help with natural disasters. Today, I have more than 500,000 soldiers.
I am the Air Force, and I am the youngest branch of the armed forces. I am responsible for the operations in air and space. In wartime, I support ground troops in battle and protect them from air attack. In peacetime, I track hurricanes, conduct weather research, and take part in space exploration. I have over 400,000 airmen today.
I am the Navy, and I maintain command of the sea. In wartime, I seek out and destroy the enemy on, under, and above the sea. In peacetime, I carry food and medical supplies to disaster areas. Today, I have 400,000 sailors.
I am the Marine Corps. In wartime, I attack the enemy from the water. I have been the first to fight in almost every major war of the United States.
In peacetime, I provide security for naval stations and ships and guard the U.S. embassies in other countries. Today, I have over 200,000 leathernecks.
I am the Coast Guard and become an active part of the Navy during wartime. In peacetime, I fight smuggling of drugs, protect ships, and rescue victims of sea disasters. I also aid ships at sea for navigation. Today, I have over 40,000 men.
Where would our country be today without our armed forces? We say thank you to all our veterans who have served our country so bravely. We salute them.
Of the U.S. Armed Forces maintains its own military marching band to inspire troops and preserve tradition. Though they now serve ceremonial functions, these bands were once an integral element on the battlefield. To increase the morale and the courage of the men, bands would march in front of formations as they entered battle. As the number of musicians dwindled, commanders delegated marching bands to the rear of the formation, behind the combat-ready troops. Today, bands are no longer involved in armed conflict, but continue to inspire troops through song or hymn that represent the individual histories and traditions of America's armed forces.
Now to inspire us, our band, directed by Miss Jessica Lozana, and our chorus will play and sing Marches of the Armed Forces, which is a medley of the services branches. Marines, the Marines hymn. Army, the Army goes rolling along. Coast Guard, Semper Paratus. Air Force, the U.S. Air Force. Navy, anchors away.
Thank you.
missing in action is a casualty classification assigned to soldiers, military chaplains, combat medics, and prisoners of war who are reported missing during wartime or ceasefire. They have been killed, wounded, captured, or deserted. As of this time, over 82,000 Americans are classified as MIA, dating all the way back to World War II. Our country promises every man and woman who are sent into combat that they will be brought back home. If they are MIA, proudly, our nation never stops looking for its lost soldiers, no matter how long it takes. If you've ever been to a military ball, stepped inside of a chow hall, or attended at a Military Veterans Association in your local community, you've likely noticed a small round table that is always set but never occupied, the Prisoners of War / Missing in Action table. The tradition of setting a separate table in honor of our POWs and missing comrades has been in place since the end of the Vietnam War. The manner in which this table is decorated is full of special symbols to help us remember our brothers and sisters in arms. The POW/MIA table is smaller than the others, symbolizing the fragility of one person alone against his or her oppressors. This table is separate from the others and can be set for 1 to 4 place settings to represent each service participating in the event. The white tablecloth draped over the table represents the purity of their response to our country's call to arms. The empty chair depicts an unknown face representing no specific soldier, sailor, airman, or marine, but all who are not here with us. The table itself is round to show that our concern for them is never ending. And the Bible represents faith in a higher power and the pledge to our country, founded as one nation under God. The black napkin stands for the emptiness these warriors have left in the hearts of their families and friends. A purple heart medal can be pinned to the napkin. The single red rose reminds us of their families and loved ones. The red ribbon represents the love of our country, which inspired them to answer the nation's call. The yellow candle and its yellow ribbon symbolize the everlasting hope for a joyous reunion with those yet accounted for.
The slices of lemon on the bread plate remind us of their bitter fate. The salt upon the bread plate represents the tears of their families. The glass turned upside down reminds us that our distinguished comrades cannot be with us to drink a toast or join in the festivities of the evening. Let us not forget all of our POWs and MIAs and remember how lucky we are to be here together, honoring the accomplishments of all of our veterans.
Thank you for keeping us all safe and the USA free from harm. Thank you for being strong. Thank you for being brave, even in the scariest situations. Most importantly, thank you for all being there.
Dear veterans, I can only imagine the sacrifices that you have made to protect the freedom of so many people. I have been fortunate enough to have many veterans in my family. Each of them was in a different branch of the military. I think of them as heroes. I think of each of you here today as heroes also. Some heroes wear a cape, and some wear a uniform.
This is for the veteran who doesn't hear thank you. This is for the veteran who never got the recognition they deserved. Thank you, thank you, thank you for everything you've done. Your bravery encourages me to keep going. These are the words from talented theater students with heartfelt messages of thanks and appreciation for the lifetime of service you have given to our country. Please know that you inspire us to be our best, to try harder, and to reach higher for our dreams. You are the pride of this nation. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
Band would like to pay a special tribute to our veterans by playing Hymn to the Fallen by John Williams. A PowerPoint presentation will accompany this performance.
Thank you.
I'd like to personally thank all of our wonderful students who participated in today's program, the speakers, the violinists, chorus, band, talented theater students. Really, please give them a warm thanks.
The signing of World War I armistice took place in a railway coach near the battle zone in France. The bugle sounded, ceased firing, and the hostilities ended, marking a most significant moment in world history. While Veterans Day is typically a tribute to America's living veterans, we would like to include a moment of respect for those who have given their lives for their country. Please stand as Brent Lorio plays taps and the colors are retired.
Right, face.